As the holiday season approaches, so do our helpings of festive treats like eggnog and cookies and pies and alcohol. These foods can leave you feeling bloated as well as increase the inflammation in your body. So we've got a recipe to help mitigate the harmful effects of inflammation in today's Daily Dish. Here's what you need: coconut oil, an onion, some garlic, ginger, cumin, ground turmeric, carrots, vegetable stock, coconut milk, lemon juice, salt, and pepper. Sounds so cozy and hearty. Trudy, we've talked about inflammation on the show before, but can you quickly remind us what that means for the body?
Yeah, so when you have inflammation in the body, it can lead to many different things. When we think about all the different diseases, inflammation is at the root of most, if not all, diseases. Now, inflammation is not always a bad thing. Like, we have acute inflammation, which we need when we're trying to, let's say, write an exam or, you know, when we're trying to deliver a presentation. But chronic inflammation, that's where the problem really lies, because chronic inflammation leads to many different types of diseases.
Okay, so we're going to be making, or you're going to be making, a golden turmeric carrot soup, which is like filled with those anti-inflammatory properties. How do we start the recipe?
Okay, so the first thing I'm going to add, Tracy, is just some coconut oil. So I'll just pop that in there. And that'll be our good dose of healthy fats. So we want to make sure that we're adding a lot of different healthy fats to our meals throughout the holidays, because these healthy fats help with sugar cravings. And the other great thing about healthy fats like coconut oil is that it helps our body to absorb other vitamins as well. Okay, so we'll just put that in there, let that melt for a bit. And then next we just want to pop in some onions. And we're just cooking these onions just for a few minutes, maybe about 3 minutes, until they get nice and translucent. Okay, and then after that, we're gonna add in some garlic. Now, stress is something that we all feel during the holidays. So if you do experience stress during the holidays, you really wanna make sure that you're prioritizing your gut health. And the reason why is because your brain sends messages to your gut, and your gut sends messages to your brain. And also neurotransmitters that make us feel good and help to improve our mood, like serotonin, are actually produced in the gut. So garlic is actually a prebiotic, which is food for that good bacteria in our gut. So after I add the garlic, I'm gonna pop in some ginger. I love adding ginger to my soups and stews. Ginger has a powerful compound called gingerol, and this is a powerful anti-inflammatory as well as a powerful antioxidant. And that's really important, again, to lowering inflammation in the body. But the other thing about ginger is that it's a great digestive aid as well. So it helps to aid that digestion from all those different foods that we're eating during the holidays that you just talked about, Tracy, like eggnog and cookies and alcohol. So the next thing we're gonna do, Tracy, is add our spices. So I'm gonna add cumin, which is one of my favorite spices. I love putting it pretty much in every single dish, especially when I'm cooking during the winter. And then I'm gonna pop in some turmeric. So turmeric is the king. No, forget that. It is the queen of spices, okay? Because it's a very powerful anti-inflammatory. And that's due to that compound called curcumin. So that's what gives it its powerful anti-inflammatory properties. So I'm gonna pop that in there. All right, so next, Tracy, I'm gonna go ahead and just add in our carrots, okay? So once we put in the carrots, I'm just gonna stir everything around just to kind of coat the carrots with the spices. Now, the thing about carrots is that we all know, or most of us know, that carrots are great for our eye health because they're a great source of vitamin A. But what most people don't know about carrots is that it's actually considered to be a grounding food. So in Ayurvedic medicine, which is one of the body's oldest healing systems, it teaches us that there's seven different chakra symbols. So the root chakra represents earth-centered energy. So when we eat grounding foods like carrots, sweet potatoes, and beets that actually grow close to the ground, it carries this grounding energy and actually passes it on to you. All right, so next I'm gonna add some veggie broth in there. And then some coconut milk. I'm a huge fan of adding coconut milk, again, to my soups and stews, because it just makes it nice and creamy and velvety. And I'm all about the textures when I eat. I just like having certain textures. So I'm just gonna stir that all together. And then to finish this off, Tracy, I would just cook this for about 25 minutes. And then when it's done cooking, I just like popping in some lemon juice, and then I pop in some salt and pepper. And the reason why I like adding a little bit of lemon juice is because I find that it just brings all of the flavors together. And lemon juice is also a really great source of vitamin C that's gonna give us that extra immune support. So once this is cooked, you know, like I said, it's cooked for 25 minutes. We add in those, you know, last finishing touches. You just want to get an immersion blender, or you can, you know, put it in your regular blender too, and then just blend it up until it's nice and smooth. And there you have it. And when it's done, it looks like this.
Let's see it. Oh, that looks fantastic. What a great recipe to keep you healthy and to fill you up. It's Hearty. Thank you.